It was amazing. I think throughout the films, I got so many reactions out of the audience, laughter, tears, and that's what it's all about, isn't it? So very well received. I can't be happier.
And how important do you think that events like this are for increasing the global reach and exposure for Asian cinema in all its different beautiful forms?
Well, you know, the United Kingdom has always been one of the prestigious sort of hangouts for filmmakers. And it's very as important as it can be. This platform is a little bit unbiased when it comes to local cliques that operate all over the world. So it's strictly by merit, which is great, because if you've got a good product, it doesn't matter if you've come from a big production house or not, as long as the proof is in the pudding. And that's why it's so important to be here today.
I think something that's very obvious looking at the lineup of talent and stories in this year's festival is how strong a female presence we have, both in front and behind the camera. Are you proud to be a part of that change?
I am so proud, because for so many years, especially in South Asia, women have sort of taken the backseat. They've been big stars, but not behind the camera, as you very correctly. So I can't be prouder today. And it's good to see so many young female representatives for the fraternity.
I'm curious if you can articulate why it is so important for women to have a voice, not just in front of the camera as big stars, but like you say, as storytellers behind the camera as well. Why does that matter?
I think that women feel and see differently from men. And, as important as it is to get a male point of view, it's always important to get a female perception or ideology across as well. So, that's why it's important that women tell their stories too.
Who were the storytellers that inspired you on your own journey? Who do you look to for that inspiration?
Well, I keep telling everybody the reason I'm a filmmaker is because of this lady called Meera Nair. She's originally from India, but she's made world-class cinema. And I saw her film called Monsoon Wedding many, many years ago, and that's when I decided I wanted to do this too. And the reason I admire Miss Nair is that she created an art house film which was relatable to people all over the world, and yet it had a very South Asian flavor to it. And hopefully that's what I aspire to do.
Particularly with new platforms like Netflix, we're seeing an ever-expanding global reach for South Asian storytelling. Why do you think that is so important to engage with the rest of the world and to reach those new markets?
Well, it's a very simple answer to that. It's the money that you have, especially indie filmmakers don't have the money to distribute or market their films as well as they should. And then they're competing with mainstream cinema. So it's platforms like Netflix that make it accessible to audiences, and I'm very proud to announce that Pinky Memsahib is now globally on Netflix, so everyone can watch it. And it's platforms and occasions like these that sort of get them known so that people actually click on the button and watch it. So I feel digital cinema, digital platforms are the future, especially for young filmmakers who want to break into the industry.